All right, here we go. Very quick 1 hour session after work, Friday afternoon, April 12th. Had a change of plans thanks to things at work working against me as always. So, you know, I happened to an opportunity. I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna go to the bar, get a burger, a delicious beer, I'm gonna go fishing. Then I'll go to the bar, get a delicious burger and a beer. So, we're back at the infamous ice out pond from last year's first video of open water. You know, where we had Andrew caught that 7.5, and I caught a couple of little dinks. So, water is already 50 degrees. Weather conditions really haven't been that promising the last 2 days, but I don't know, might catch a few. So I'm gonna try out here over the top of this grass real quick because I've seen them up here before in these conditions. It's a little late in the day, but I figure, you know what, it's right beside the bolt launch. I'll give it a shot before I burn time going across the other side. I just changed to my swim bait with a little underspin. I'm gonna drag it. Before jig, jerk bait, lipless crankbait, and spinner bait. That's all I had time for before you showed up. Did you hear me beep when I went by? Did you hear me beep when I was driving by?
I might have.
It's like, oh, beep, beep, pause, beep, 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 beep. No, I couldn't. There was... Oh, dude, he thumped it so hard. I think it's small, but damn, he ate it. He's tiny. On the fall, bud. Oh, that's awesome. Get him. Ooh, a bunch of bait fish just went by too. Look at how he ate this. Yeah, on the fall with the little swim bait, he hungry. Little Kitech 3.8 inch. Hey, you know what, we got one. For the effort so far, we got the one. That makes me happy. Oh, hell yeah. That's the first one I've caught on an underspin, but this is also the first time I've ever thrown an underspin, so. I am curious to see what the water temp's gonna be. Oh God, what are you looking at?
My fat butt.
So I don't know if I said it. I know I said the date, Saturday, April 13th. It's 75 degrees out. It's nice, if you couldn't tell by the shorts and the flip-flops. So I'm curious to see what the water temp's gonna be, but I gotta let the puck catch up a little bit. It's saying 55 right now, but there's no way it's 55. Just no way. That's a fish this time. Yeah, buddy. Couple good head shakes in there, too. Yeah. Where you at? Let me get a look at you. It's a largie. Just can't tell how big it is. Guess where he was? Give one guess. What are we coming here for? Yeah, that's a nice one. Yes! Yes! Ned Rig strikes again. There you go. Nice little chunky guy on the Ned Rig. On my old school setup, although I've kind of revised it, Sankore Mojo Bass with that Lose Mach 2 speed spin. Down she goes. Real simple. The small TRD from, I forget off the top of my head all of a sudden, but little Ned Rig, just easy peasy. Z-Man, that's what it was. And he was down in the middle of all those rocks. It's a good fight for how cold it is. Water's 48. That is for sure. It's been holding steady at 48 point something. You're really low, like 48.1 to 48.3. Gotta give it to him slow. What do I have for different trailers? Because I'm not really feeling the Rage Craw at the moment. Oh, that works. Nice little shimmy. I typically don't like the ribbed swim bait style as trailers on a chatterbait. because it just something about the combination of the skirt and the ribbed profile, it doesn't make the tail kick well. But when you get like just the slim body paddle tail swim baits behind a skirt like this, specifically a chatterbait, you still get good action. There's something about the blade on the chatterbait and that erratic action with the ribbed style. Yeah, nice subtle kick. That works. Oh, so close. There we go. Yep. Yeah, dude, that feels real good. Woo-hoo-hoo! I thought I hit a branch, buddy. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Oh, my God. Oh. That's got to be a PB.
Dude, that's a PB.
My.
Look at his shoulders on that.
Oh, my.
What does he have in his mouth?
Dinner. Breakfast. Holy God. Move out of the way.
Oh,
dude.
God, dude.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Holy. Scales in the glove box.
That's a catfish.
All right, so PB is 6.25.
6.25. That's got to be 6.
It, dude, it, oh my God.
That's got to be 6. High fives.
That might be my, that, I'm feeling confident. I've got my second 6 in my life. No, 6.02, come on.
What do you mean no? Oh, come on.
Dude, I thought it was going to go higher. I really thought it was going to be closer to 6.5 just because look at how chunky it is. All right, wait, here we go, number 2.
I'll even get my scale too and check it.
Go ahead. 602.
602?
602, that's...
You got a 6, are you kidding me?
Oh.
You got a backflip off the boat.
I'm not backflipping off the boat, water's too cold. Where's your scale?
Mine is.
Oh my God, dude, this thing is stout. Are you kidding me? All right, picture time.
Dude, whew. What was that on?
My God, chatterbait.
Get the hell out of here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, picture time, absolutely.
Dude, this is a black and blue Z-Man with a little Strike King Rage, a little swim bait on the back.
Yep.
Nice, thanks, buddy.
Dude. Whew. And he just ate, and he just smoked that.
602. That's my second biggest fish in my entire life.
Dude, my second biggest fish ever came out of here. Your second biggest fish ever came out of here.
Oh, my God. Dude, I'm so amped. So.
Yes, dude, that's awesome. I'm so happy for you right now. Oh, that thing's huge.
I honestly thought I hit a branch because it just stopped. And it wasn't like, you know, a good thumping bite you typically get, like with a spinner bait or something. It just stopped. Hook sets are free, though. Holy. Whew. And did you see what I did? We were beyond that tree. And I threw it up to those two dead ones and I kind of came back around.
I'm so happy for you. That's so sad.
Wait. Tina.
Yeah, take a break.
I'm just going to let that digest for a minute. So that was, you know, again to reiterate, that was on that Z-Man chatterbait. And I think it's a 3/8. And it's the Strike King, like, Rage swim bait. It's kind of like a Kitech. It's really small. Typically, I don't like the ribbed style swim baits on these. Like, the smoother body ones go a little bit better. But this is good because something about the blade interferes with the action of the tail when you got that ribbed one. But with this, it's got a very subtle kick, so I can move it really slow, and it's just, it waves just nicely. And that was the first fish on the Lose BB1 speed spool. Which I got this because it's kind of going to be my heavyweight. I've got two of them. One of them's going to be, you know, chatterbaits, spinnerbaits, swimbaits, all sorts of things, glide bait. So, good way to break it in. 6'2", second biggest fish of my life. All right. So ends 3 straight days of fishing. And I only had 3 fish to show for it. You know, Friday we had that one on the Kitech on the underspin. Saturday, I had the one on the Ned rig. Today, I had the one on the chatterbait. At least today's was a really good fish. I mean, it's kind of understating how good that fish was. This is the second biggest fish I've ever caught in my life. But, man, I don't know what's going on with this weather other than, you know, Friday wasn't really great as far as weather goes. We got there really late in the day, too. This time of the year, it's not really what you want to be doing as everything's starting to cool down. And then, you know, yesterday, we picked a pond that really we probably shouldn't have been at. It iced out about 2 weeks later than everything else, so you know it was still pretty cold. And then, but today, I have no idea what the heck happened today. It was a tough weekend, and today was no exception. I mean, the weather's nice. Maybe it's a high pressure. I don't know, but maybe it'll turn on a little bit later. But I just don't have the time. Unfortunately, I got to get back home to my family and get things done before the weekend's completely over. We did try a lot of things. We did commit to the jig pretty hard and trying to hit structure out on the deep side of it. We did fish a lot of open water though too. We covered all our bases. We threw everything in the boat with the exception of probably the glide bait. I think that's the only thing we didn't throw. But we had everything covered. And we gave everything a pretty good shake too. I even gave the jerk bait quite a bit of a workout, even though it's still not my favorite thing to do, though I do feel better about it than I have in quite a while. But just not in the cards. Might still be a little too early. It's not really an excuse. That's a little too early for my experience and skill at this point. But I'm learning, and I'm getting better, and that's the most important thing. Time in the water is the best teacher. Can't really say that today was super beneficial from a learning standpoint because, I mean, I tried everything, and I tried changing things up a little bit too, and, you know, with the exception of that one bass, we had nothing. Andrew did have a bite early, like second or third cast this morning. And it was in the areas we expected them to be in, but you know, aside from that, it was tough even marking fish. So it is what it is, especially early in the year. Just some days, even though everything looks like it's going to line up to be a good one, you know, that's three straight days where it didn't really pan out. So, oh well, hopefully by next weekend, weather's a lot better and things start turning on, we'd start doing a lot better. So that'll wrap it up. Thank you all for watching. Greatly appreciate it, as always. You do me a favor, if you watch all the time, if you could subscribe, please, I'd greatly appreciate it. And, you know, sharing the video is also really key for helping grow the channel. I know I say that in the giveaways and everything too, but seriously, like, growth, it's half me, half the community. You guys definitely drive growth, not just for me, but for other channels too. So, thank you all very much. Catch you in the next one.